Hello everyone, my name is Abhay Valsankar and today I'll introduce myself in a different way since the topic that we are looking on hand is nothing but students' stress buster. So I would introduce myself as Abhay Valsankar, a lifelong learner or a student of life. So as we all know, all of us throughout our life have been a student at some point or the other in our life. Continues to be, and life is basically the biggest syllabus that we have and it's an exam that we all prepare for. But as we go ahead in today's world, we find that many of the youth of the country, the students are going through tremendous stress in their life, and then the question arises, what is the whole point of this education system and how can I reduce my stress to make sure that the students do better? So today we focus on that part of the element. So to begin, let us see a few quick observations as we go ahead. The very first, as we can see, today we have 78 organs in our human body. But science has shown that nowadays the current youth have a 79th organ also. And that is nothing but a mobile phone, a cell phone that we all have. That's the only organ which is not a part of the body. It is external, but without that we cannot function as human beings. So for students, cell phone is like their 79th organ in their body. Now, if we take out our cell phone, and since all of us have got smartphones, if we Google this thing, which is nothing but university makes me, or college makes me, or education makes me, and if we see the top search that arrives in Google, this is what you find in that top search, which is nothing but university makes me feel sad, feel stupid, feel cry, feel failure, feel anxious, feel depressed, and depressed to an extremely different whole level together. Now that makes us wonder, why does this happen? Why is Google giving predictive answers which are all negative when it comes to education today? And when so much of negativity is around education, it is bound to create the stress that we have in our heads, and that is why students go through it today, which creates them to do a lot of things which we ideally don't want any of us, our friends, our kids to go ahead and do it. So this is for each and every student out there. The next 45 minutes to 1 hour is for you, so make sure you don't miss it. This is what education system does, the stress, why is it caused, and the reasons how to overcome that stress, how to eliminate it, how to treat it in a way that we can all be back to the country that we were, and the education system is again established to the level what it was when we started. So let us take a few comparisons as we go all around, because when we compare something to someone, it becomes easier for us to understand our level of progress. Now let us do that while considering this. How many of us have seen this telephone in our old days? Maybe way back, say 50 years back, 100 years back, 150 years back, this was the telephone that people used to use. It had a round dial, and if you wanted to hear, you should keep it like this, you have to speak like this. So it was a whole together a different story 100 years back, and that was a telephone that we had during those days. If you consider the current situation of the telephones, of the cell phones, this is how the cell phone looks today. Completely changed in terms of the technology, in terms of the size, in terms of the processor, in terms of the abilities. The old phone, you could just say hi, hello, you could talk to the other person. Some cases you had to wait for the other person to finish, then you could speak. But in today's world, it is duplex. You can speak at the same time, you can chat, you can go on internet. Some of us are right now watching this video on our cell phone. This shows how much it has grown in the last few years, specifically comparing to a 100-year period. Now if we consider a second example in the same comparative study, this is what a car 100 to 150 years before used to look like. It is nothing but a horse cart. There used to be a horse, there used to be people sitting behind, and then the car had one horsepower as it went ahead driving in different streets of the country. Now today if you consider cars, some of the cars are supercars like this who have horsepower up to 16 bhp, 16 horsepower, which is equivalent to 16 horses in front of your carriage. Cars have developed so much in the course of 100 years that today when you look at a car, it is nowhere as what it was maybe 50 or 100 years back. See the drastic changes between these two things that we have come along for such a long time. But now if you consider the third case, and this is where I'm scared, and this is what frightens me, because when you look at this, this is a classroom which was there 100 years before. So way back in the 1800s, in the 1900s, this is how a classroom used to look. So there used to be tables, there used to be students sitting there on chairs, there used to be one professor, there used to be one blackboard, and that is how they used to teach 100 years, 150 years ago. And now the scariest part is this, that this is how the classroom looks even today, which is nothing but exactly the same. Now that makes us wonder, when technology has risen 10 times, 100 times over the past 100 years, where has our education system developed? It's absolutely the same if you consider the way it approaches. There is a teacher, there are students, the teacher says something, the students make sure they note it down, the students go to an exam, they write it down, and then if you get good marks, you are considered intelligent. But now the whole problem in this system is, you are evaluated for your memory power, your retention power, kitna achha ratta maar sakta hai is what you are evaluated on. You are not evaluated on the understanding of a particular subject. And this is why the education system today becomes one of the biggest failures for upcoming students, and that leads to a competition which student doesn't want to be a part of but has to be a part of, which increases the stress level and which makes them do things which are not something that we would want to do as students ourselves. So today we have a little awareness done on these issues to make sure that we as a student, as a lifelong learner, take these few things in our mind as we go ahead, and we encourage other students who are around us, the youth of the country, the kids, to not fall into this trap of expectations, which what the modern world called as education. So let us see a few more details before we head towards how to eliminate the stress. First, let us understand what causes stress in the mind of students in today's era. So here is a version which is a democratic version of what a students feel. So I want all of us to pay attention to this, because this is something which is the most important part, how stress is developed to a student level. The education system today that we have is completely outdated as compared to the education system that is necessary for the growing world. Let us take simple examples. Consider a case wherein this used to happen in my college. So when I was in my polytechnic, in my diploma college, there was a rule in our college. If somebody is found using a cell phone, that cell phone is to be taken by the principal and it is to be kept in that office. And at the end of the course, so the course was 3 years, at the end of the course, you get the cell phone back. And this was a rule that we had during our days, just to make sure that none of us are on cell phones and we are paying attention to the lecture. Now, if we consider that in today's era, in the country that we live in, it is almost a crime if you are not an engineer or a doctor. So in India, the concepts are very clear. You are born, you are a guy, you are an engineer. You are a girl, you are a doctor. But today we are in a world wherein everybody is so fascinated by engineering that it has become the new normal. So you become an engineer, then you decide what you want to do in your life. This is what the level we have come to. Now if we consider a typical example of engineering, 4 years of course. Imagine, let us take a case. I enter engineering first year in the year 2009. Now let us take a comparative study of the timeline with respect to the technology advancement used in our cell phones. So majority of us here are Android users. Let us consider in the year 2009, the Android version which was going on the day I took the admission was nothing but the very first version of Android. Now consider I am talking in the class on my cell phone. My cell phone is taken away and kept in the principal's office. Now I complete my 4 years of engineering, and 2013, when I come out of the college, the Android versions in the cell phone have gone up to 20 times. What was level 1 and level 2 here, if you see, it has gone to level 21, 22. What we were in terms of the first version, it has then gone up to Android cupcake, then you have donut, you have eclair, you have pie, it has come down to such levels. There have been 20 different variations in the advancement in the technology. Now when after 4 years, imagine that cell phone comes out of that college, comes out of that principal's office. Now is the cell phone capable of handling the changes around? Would we use the same cell phone in that era? No. Why? Because now we want the updated cell phone. What will I do of a cell phone which has got an Android 1 version? Now we know that when it comes to technology, when it comes to us as human beings, we don't realize that. When we enter an academic institute today, we enter for the syllabus which is set way back in the early 90s, early 2000s. Now we are studying that today, and then we expect to go out in the world and have great jobs. How is it possible to be prepared for the jobs which are there today if we study something which is completely outdated and completely obsolete? And that is the biggest factor which creates stress in the minds of people, because now you're running a race which you don't want to run, but the problem is you cannot fail. And you are failing at something which you don't want to do. So it's a dead end. It's a circle in which we are stuck. And that is why it is extremely important for us to realize that today we live in a world wherein it changes every single day, and therefore the way we learn, the way we study has to change also as we go along. Let us take a few more comparative study as we go ahead. These are the top trending jobs which were there for the last 2 years. So if you have a look at the jobs that you see on screen, some of them include 3D printing specialist, some of them include vloggers, some of them include UX designer, the user interface designer, some are big data, chief listening, drone operator. These are some of the words which 5 years back, none of them have heard about it. And today, after 4 years of engineering, when you come out, these are the jobs in the market, but none of this is taught to you in the college. And that is what creates the biggest gap, which leads to the biggest stress in minds of students. So you are actually learning something in college, which you are not going to use when you go out in the outer world. And that is how we end up having 3 years, 4 years, 5 years of our education, learning nothing but to score marks. And marks which we feel are going to define us. But we don't realize they don't define us at all. They define our memory power. They do not define our understanding. They do not define how well have we got stuff. And that is why when we go out in the world, we have such jobs which weren't present 4 years back when we took admission into a college. And that is why we need to prepare to go to a next level to make sure we eliminate this stress and we are prepared for a better learning experience as we go ahead. And to do that, that is an exact system that we have developed to make sure that each student out there does not fall into the trap of being stressed under the expectations of the world, rather follows what is extremely simple, and we treat stress in a very simple way, step by step. So to do that, let us understand what this gentleman here has to say. So he's one of the leading entrepreneurs who says this, that there will be as many changes in the technology in the next 6 years. So from 2016 to 2022, there will be so many changes which will be more than changes what were from 1900 to 2000. To in simple words, 100 saal mein jitna technology badla tha from 1900 to 2000, agle 6 saal mein utse zyada technology badlega. This is the pace at which technology is increasing. So what has happened is in the past, we are in the present, but people are planning for the future. So technology is changing at such a vast speed, and that is why we as students have to keep pace with it and make sure that we learn on our own selves to go ahead and achieve what we want. How do we do that is what we come to see. Now, when you look at, consider at this case, this is the main region, this is the origin of the entire education system and why it is so pakao, so boring, so useless in today's world. Let us go back to the year 1800, 1835. So as we all know, the Britishers had their colony set up in India and they wanted to make sure they have control on the Indians. Now, before British came into the country, every one of us know that India used to be the Sone Ki Chidiya. It was the center, it was the hub of learning, it was a learning capital of the world, wherein universities like Nalanda were the number one in the world. People used to come all the way from the outside, from the other countries to Nalanda to come and visit for learning, not for marks. But what has happened today as we grew ahead is, in somewhere around 1800, 1830, when the Britishers were colonizing India, they had one of their parliamentarians who was sent to India. His name was Lord Macaulay. Now, he was sent on a simple mission, go to India, we want to establish a strong base in India, waha pe jao and tell us, observe things, how can we dominate India more. So he came here for 4 years, he observed each and everything about India and the Indians, he went back to the UK Parliament and on 2nd February 1835, he gave this as a speech in their Parliament. This is a small extract from that speech wherein he says, I have travelled across the length and breadth of the country and I found that there is no one who is a beggar, who is poor, who is stiff, who are all are higher in their values. There is only one thing that can change them, that is if we change their culture. And to do that, the easiest form is to change the base, which was nothing but the education system of the country. And that is how from the year 1835, the old education system was driven away, the education system which was based on values was driven away, and now a new education system was established based on only one condition, which is nothing but English education. Since that was their biggest strength, that was their knowledge, that was what they had to offer, they made it mandatory to make sure that we have English as a primary language for education. Now, if I don't know English, if someone else knows English, automatically this person is a higher authority as compared to me. So I'm going to follow him blindly to make sure that happens. This is what Lord Macaulay did. He came back and made sure Indians treat English as not a language, but as a class. And that is where we faltered. We no more treat English as just a language. No, we treat it as a class. So if there are two people in theater, one is talking in Hindi, "Hey, kaisa hai movie, kaisa chal raha hai, sab theek hai?" We are like, "Hey, shh, don't make noise." But if someone speaks in English, "Oh, what a wonderful movie, such a great scene." We feel good. Wow, we are in a good environment. Everybody speaking in English. It's like a classy people, white collar, A-class people. Now we don't realize for us this has become a class, this is no more a language, which creates problem for us. So when the whole education system was developed, before 1835, it was based on learning, values and principles. After 1835, when Lord Macaulay came to India, he developed an education system with an outcome driven education. So he was something with a concept saying, jo padha hai, wo utilize karna chahiye, output dikhana chahiye. So what you have learned has to be developed in such a way that you earn something out of it. That was his point. Make sure that education is to be utilized. Now to do that, he developed the education system which is called as a STEM-based education system. Now when you talk about STEM-based education system, it is nothing but science, technology, engineering and mathematics. So these were the four subjects that were given maximum importance. Everything else was considered useless. It is not required. Why wasn't it required? Because if you consider in the 1800, there was an industrial revolution in the entire country, especially in India and across in the British also. So they wanted someone who could go to college, when after the college is done, they can work as factory workers. And that was the point, how the entire education system was developed on the basis of STEM, which is nothing but science, technology, engineering and management in terms of mathematics. Now, why weren't there any artists? Why weren't there any singers? Why weren't there any dancers? Because practically in a factory, you don't have to have a dancer to come and work. You don't have to have a singer to come and work. All you need is basic factory workers. And that is why the education system was developed to make sure that you are capable of listening to things what people say, following what they say and do it exactly in the same way without questioning anything. And that is how our basis of education was developed during the second half of the entire educational drama. Now when that happened, some of the changes that we discovered were this. We considered today, when it comes to the STEM, the four main subjects which is science, technology, engineering and mathematics, India is ranked second in the whole world. We produce maximum engineers in the whole world as compared to even China. If you look at the population, they have a higher population, but we have the maximum number of engineers in the world. But yet if we consider the happiness index, we are nowhere close to what we should be. And that is how even today people struggle and people have stress, because we are a result, we are an output of something happened way back which hasn't been changed all this while. To continue ahead, let us take a look at what Einstein had to say about this whole thing. So Einstein compares the education system to the image that you see here on screen. And in that image, if you see, so there is a monkey, there is a bird, there is an elephant, a fish, a penguin, a dog and a professor who says that to keep a fair test for everyone, everybody has to climb that tree. So the test given to everyone is to climb a tree. Now this is what Einstein said. That everybody is a genius, but if you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, the fish will live whole of his life believing it was stupid. Puri zindagi machli ko aise hi lage ki main stupid hu yaar, main chadh nahi pa raha hu ped. We don't realize fish was not meant to go up the tree. But this is what education system makes us do. It keeps everybody on board together on the same platform and it says, tu bhi yehi kar, tu bhi yehi kar. Jo achha karega, usko A grade. Doesn't sound it familiar to what the batching system we had in industries? Go back to our schools. How does our school start? It starts with a bell, ting, 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 ting. Go back to industries. How does the industrial workers' times used to start? With a bell. They had a lunchtime, bell used to ring, everybody used to go for lunch. That is what happens today. Products were batched on an assembly line. If the product was good, it was stamped as okay, A grade product. If it was not, it was eliminated. What happens in our education system? If you pass, great, good, A grade. If you fail, no, go back, do the same. And this is the biggest problem that we have in our education system. Let us take a minute and understand that why today education system is such a problem and which leads to a stress. Let us take a simple example. If you consider different words which are written here, all the words, the first three tend to sound a little similar to each other. So if I say we had to spell the word education, which we all have, which we have taken, education, which one do you think is the right spelling for education?
First one.
The first one, pretty simple. Now, the first one is the correct one. Let us see what the current education system does and how it grades and judges students. Consider if we had to give a spelling of education. So out of these words, it is pretty evident that the very first spelling is the correct one, which is E-D-U-C-A-T-I-O-N, education. Makes sense, great. If you see the second spelling, A-D-U-C-A-T-I-O-N, one letter mistake, very close. If you see the next, education, tomato and banana. Now if you consider the closest to the optimal answer, then yes, education is the closest to the optimum answer which we want. But what does our system do? Our system says education is as wrong as tomato, is as wrong as banana. And that is the biggest problem today. So for us, kisi ko agar samjha hai, thodi si zarurat hai aur samajhne ki, aur kisi ko bilkul bhi nahi samjha hai, education comes and brings on the same platform saying you are also wrong, you are also wrong. It is not divided according to the learning capacity of the student, it is divided onto the age group of the student. And that is the saddest part about the education system. You go in other countries, take US as a case study, there if you have the learning ability which is greater than your age group, they let you go into the next age group. They don't consider you that, okay, you're only 10 years old, you can't fit into the next class. No. It is here in India that we go by the age group. We don't go by the learning ability. And that is why this is what Einstein said, that everybody is a genius. But you cannot let a fish climb a tree because the fish would lead all of its life thinking that it was stupid. And that is what we do as a part of an education system. And that is why it is obsolete and needs complete repair, complete changeover as we go ahead. This is what the system is. It is nothing but a factory. A factory wherein a product is produced, a factory wherein engineers are developed, doctors are developed, lawyers are developed. What have you learned? Nothing. But what do we have? We have a degree. And that is what the difference is. So this is what one of the education specialists from the country said, that the Indian scholars are the best in the world. Now the Indian students can go to any country and all the countries agree that Indian students are the best in the world. Now the problem here is they are the best in the world because not of education, but they are the best in the world in spite of the education in the country. Remember the difference. It is not ki education se unko wo mila hai. Education ke bawajood wo number one hai dunya mein. And this is the true sense in which we call it as a system. Consider Nobel laureates. India in science has got only one Nobel laureate. Now, as we go ahead, when you consider China, China has got way more. US has got way more. You consider gold medals in 24 different Olympics, India alone, consider gold, bronze, all the medals clubbed together, we have 26 gold medals. We have 26 gold, then bronze, and then silver medals, everything kept together. You consider China, in the Beijing Olympics alone, they had 100 plus medals. Now, why does this happen? This happens right from the grassroots is what we are trying to look at. The reasons why the students are stressed is because they are in a system which is obsolete, which creates a problem. So as we go ahead, as you can see, it's a factory wherein your creativity is never ever in question. Nobody cares if you are a creative person. Everybody cares if you can remember things. Memory test karta hai. And that is why a competitive exam is the biggest hurdle of the country. Because it is as simple as that. If your answer is wrong, you get zero. Nobody cares about your understanding. They just care about marks. And that is what stops the students from going ahead. And that is what leads to a mindset which is full of stress. Here's a stat which was released in the Economic Times, which was said by the CEO of Mahindra. And this is what he says, 94%, now this is a huge number, and this comes right from within the country. It says 94% of the engineering graduates are unemployable. Wo job karne ke layak nahi hai. This is what the CEO of Tech Mahindra, says. Now we wonder why is it so. Let us take a simple example. My elder brother graduated in the year 2004 and he graduated in the stream of civil engineering from a college in Mumbai. He got an annual package of 3 lakh rupees on an entire year. That year, way back in 2004. Today, on 2019, I have friends who are in that same institute, the same company visits today and gives a package of 3 lakh per annum. How many years have gone by? 15 years. How much increase in salary package? Zero. It was 3 lakh in 2004, it is 3 lakh in 2019. Nothing has changed in terms of the salary, but if you see the number of graduates around there, it has gone 10x, it has gone 100x. And that is where we have maximum people who are qualified with a degree, but have no skill to even operate in a company. And that is an eye-opener for us. Imagine we are up to something, but we have no skills, we have no knowledge, but we have a degree to say. How would it work out? And that is why the stress levels go high in our body. Because we don't understand what is happening, we are a failure of the system. This is what Einstein says, and this is one of my favorite quotes. It takes a minute to understand, but the moment you do, you realize what it was. And the quote is nothing but this: the only thing that interferes with my learning is my education. Now, if we consider throughout our life, we think education equal to learning. This is not the case. Education is the test of your memory. Learning is how we learn, how we grow, how we develop. These are two different things. But we think education is learning. No. He goes on to say in one of the things that people enter an institute, people enter a college not to learn the syllabus. They learn how to learn. And that is why you should enter a college. Not just to ratify a book, but you go there. Today, IIM has such a high value. Not because of the syllabus. The syllabus is standardized, it's the same. It's because of the people inside in IIM that has the mindset that helps you to develop to that level. And that is why today this is what we should follow. We should enter a world when we are independent of learning. We are no more dependent on a system that drives us to do the same thing, which is obsolete, which is bad, which is gone down few years back, but we're still doing it as we are going along. So this is for us as an eye-opener to make sure we go ahead. Now, whenever we have stress in our head, this is what it is, right? We have never-ending stress. Now, we know the reasons why we have stress. Now, we come to a point, how do we eliminate this stress? How do we treat this stress to a level that it does not affect us and we can have a good health and a good body and a fresh mind to learn more and to become a lifelong learner as we go ahead? So the very first in this is how typically a worried person looks, right? The body language is all dull, he has his shoulders down, he's walking like this. Nahi yaar, kuch toh gadbad hai. People who look at such a person immediately come to know, no, something is wrong. Chakkar aa raha hai, ghoom raha hai sir, it's not right. Take a second case. If a student is preparing for an exam, is all stressed out, this is how the typical student is. Again, shoulders down, thinking, constantly worried, kya hoga, kya hoga. He has no clue, no happiness, no smile whatsoever. Consider the third case. This is how our parents are on a result day. Agar aapke bachche ka koi result hai, to bachcha tension leta hai, nahi leta hai, pata nahi. Parents zarur tension lete. They are always and always stressed. Always biting their nails, kya hoga? Will he crack the JEE exams? Will he crack the CAT exam, CET exam, medical exam? Tension, 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 stress, stress, stress all along. This is typically how it is. We have stress for our education, we have for our security, relationship, financial aspects, etc., etc. Constant stress every single time, the mind is full of it. And when you're so stressed as we go along, we need someone to eliminate this stress for us. And that is what we are going to learn today, how to treat the stress and have a much more peaceful life as a student and as a lifelong learner. So to begin with, let us start with the very first concept. Now, when we start, this is what a harsh reality of the country today is. When you have such a high stress level, this is what the result shows, that every 55 minutes, which might be the length of this talk, so when I started the talk and by the time I end, there is at least one Indian student who is going to commit suicide. And this is the fact. Every 55 minutes, an Indian student commits a suicide. For the last 3 years, 26,000 students have committed suicide in India. And then we wonder, why? What's wrong? What's happening? Okay, one student cannot take a stress. It's not about one student. 26,000 people doing the same thing because they don't want to do what they are forced to do. But do we encourage our child, our kids, our students, our friends to do something that they love? We never. Why? Because we have seen more successful engineers around us. We have seen more successful doctors around us. So we encourage our kids, our children, our friends to follow that because we have seen in the society that they are successful and they get paid well. If there comes a time when everybody around us is a cricketer, suddenly we would feel cricket is something that you should do. Then you would start forcing your kid, "Jaake cricket khelo." But today we are in a day wherein everybody has a right to choose what they want to do. And that is how, with the very first step to eliminate this, we have to ensure that all these are warning signs for a student. So if you ever feel stressed, go out, seek help, talk to your friends, talk to your family, talk to anyone around. There are helplines throughout, but make sure that you do not let it affect your health. So if you have stress, we need to treat it, and it begins with the very first step, which is nothing but the T in the treat. So as you can see on the board, to treat stress, the very first thing that you should do is you should find your tribe. Now, what do you mean by find your tribe? A tribe is nothing but a group of like-minded people who helps you to learn what you want to learn. Now, say for example, all of us here at Help Library are nothing but a tribe. So all of us are here to learn something every day in the form of guest lectures that we have. So you are a tribe by yourself. So congratulations, the first step is already done for being a part of a tribe. Very, very important. Now, why is this tribe so very essential? Let us look at the first quote here. It goes and it says like this, that you are the average of five people that you spend your time with. Aapke aaju baju ke jo panch log hai, aap unka average ban jate ho. Take a simple example. If five of people around you whom you spend your daily time with, if they drink alcohol, you would also start drinking alcohol. If they smoke cigarettes, so if we have to treat our stress, the number one to start is nothing but the T, wherein you have to find your tribe. Now, what is a tribe? A tribe is nothing a group of like-minded people who have common pain points. When they come along and they discuss on what their issues are, help each other to solve them and go ahead. The reason why we say is this, because your network determines your net worth. Aapka jo asli dhan hai, wo aapke dost hai, wo aapke sahakari hai. Those are the people around you. So if you have the brightest minds around you, definitely you are going to scale up in our life. But if you have someone who tries to pull you down, definitely you are going to go down. So remember this, you are the average of five people around you. Aapke aaju baaju jinke saath aap samay bitate ho, aap unke average ho, aap un jaise ban jate ho. Now, there's one of my favorite quote which I love the most. It is nothing but this. If you are the best in the group, it's time you change the group. Agar aap aapke grape group mein sabse best ho, to waqt aa chuka hai ki aap wahan se change karke koi aur group mein chale jao. And that is how you learn. That is a new cycle of learning that you have. To make sure that number one, you find a tribe, a group of like-minded people, jinke saath aap rehkar aapka stress kam ho sakta hai. The second step as we go along is nothing but reward. So in your treat, in the way of treating our stress, the second is nothing but reward. Now, this is what we have been doing for the last many, many years. This is what we have done with our friends, our colleagues, our kids. We have a simple concept. 99% marks laoge, to ghadi, varna chadi. We have a simple concept. So if you get good marks, you get a watch, else watch out, I'm going to hit you. So you set rewards, but to results. And that is what creates stress. That is what creates expectation. So what we should do ideally to eliminate stress is we should set rewards for actions instead of results, which simply means what? कि अगर मैं घर पे बैठा हूँ, remote वहाँ पे पड़ा है, बहुत आलसी हूँ उठने के लिए, but if I get up and I collect the remote, I should reward myself for the fact that I just got up. वो action के लिए मुझे खुद को reward करना है, ना कि result के लिए. So the next time if you have a student who has exams, maybe it's your child, your kid, your friends, whoever, tell them you would get a reward if you study for these many time, if you consider these concepts are clear, if you explain me these concepts, go for the learning rather than the result. Don't say exam mein 90% marks lao to mobile milega. Nahi. Ye bolo ki agle hafte tak roj mujhe char nayi cheeze sikhao. Whatever you have learned from your book, try to explain it to me. Concepts clear karo. Encourage your child to do that. Let them take actions. You reward their actions and not their results. End result ke baad tohfa doge to kuch nahi hoga. Nahi milega utna percent, the child will go in depression. Thinking, nahi mil raha hai, nahi mil raha hai. But if you reward their action, it automatically develops a habit wherein after a while, because you are being so disciplined, results would automatically follow you. So it is like this. First, we make our habits. पहले हम अपने आदत बनाते हैं, then the habit makes us. Phir wo aadat hame banati hai. So we have to develop that habit of making sure that we avoid the actions and not just the results. So that is the second one. That is the R in treating stress. The first one was find your tribe. Find like-minded people. Second one is reward. Reward your actions, not just results. Now, third one and one of my favorite is this, that you have to energize your body. Everything is one thing and that one thing is energy. So the energy has to be high. Now, let us take a simple example. What do we mean by that? We simply mean that whenever we are in stress, try to observe our body language. Our body language is going to be all like this. Feeling all stressed. Shoulders are all down. Your head is all down. You have stress on your forehead. It is pretty evident that you are not happy. You are all stressed out. Now, all this while, we have heard one thing, that your mind controls your body. Everybody has heard that? That our mind controls our body. Not many know that the other way around is also possible. Your body can also control your mind. And let us see today how that is possible. Let us take a simple example. For that, all we need is to make sure we have a confident body language. But if you can see in the image, the person has developed a confident body language. He has a pump with himself. Who do you think is going to pump it for him? Kaun uske liye pump karega? It has to be he himself who has to do that. Pump available karte hai, your friends, your family, your parents are going to give you that pump. But nobody can give you self-confidence. Nobody can change your body language. You have to do it your own self. So the pump can be given, but you are the one who's going to pump yourself and use it. And that is how you develop a much happy, happy, confident body language, which makes you a superman and a superwoman. Now, why is that possible and how does it work? Let us take a simple example. If you remember, exactly 8 years ago, which is on 2nd of April in 2011, India won the World Cup after 28 years. So I was one of the privileged people who was there in the stadium to watch this match live at Wankhede. So one of my friends had given me the ticket. Now while I was there, this was the last shot which was played by MS Dhoni, that captain of the cricket team during that time. He hit a ball for 6 and the moment he did that, entire celebration in the entire country, in the world, was beyond expectation. But tell me one thing, when Dhoni hit a 6 to win us the World Cup, did we celebrate like this? Hey, jeet gaye, hey, we won the World Cup, good. Do you think we celebrated like this? No, right? Go back to our own times. You might be with your friends, with your family. The moment he hit a 6, our body language was all open. If you look at Yuvraj Singh's body language at the other end, he himself is open. And that is how it is. It's a simple concept. If you have an open body language, you cannot be sad. And if you have a closed body language, you cannot be happy. As simple as that. So the next time when you are stressed, try to observe your body language. It will be closed. Try to tell it to your mind. With a closed body language, I cannot be happy. So can I change my happiness? Not in my hand. Can I change my body? Yes, in my hand. Next time you're sitting all stressed out, get up, stretch along, change your body language a little. The moment you change your body language, you have an open body language, you become much more prone to happiness. Why? Because you cannot be sad in an open body language. Have you seen any person speaking like this? Arey boss, life ki to lag gayi hai, waat lagi hai, ekdam mast, ghar nahi hai, gaadi nahi hai, kuch nahi hai, I'm all stressed. You will never find a person with an open body language being sad. At the same time, you will never find a happy person with a closed body language. Arey, we won the World Cup, kya mast tha, bata yaar, bahut maza aaya, bahut maza aaya. Not possible. It goes hand in hand. So if you can't change the problem, at least change the body language. Come out, have an open, confident body language, and it automatically helps you to energize yourself. And that is how you can deal and eliminate stress. Step number 3, make sure you energize your body. So no matter what happens, you need to come out of that comfort zone which is making you sad to an outer world with an open body language. Once again, to quickly wind up this thought, remember this, we cannot be sad in an open body language. We cannot be happy in a closed body language. So if you're unhappy, change the body language, become happy automatically. That is how it goes hand in hand. So like in this case, automatically everybody in the stadium got up, we started hugging each other, we had an open body language. That is how you celebrate victory, that is how we celebrate happiness. We cannot do that sitting and crying at one place. So change your body language, energize, automatically the stress levels will go down. The next one, if we have to treat our stress, is nothing but in the form of this. Now, we have to assess every situation around us. So in your treat, the thing that we have to remember, the A is nothing but assess the situations. Now, what does this mean? Whenever you are prepared for situation A, life gives you situation B. Hum A ke liye prepared the, out of the syllabus question paper aa gaya, abhi hume B ke liye exam deni hai. And this is not just related to education, this is our life, right? You are prepared for one thing, life gives you a googly, something else. What do? We assess the situation at that time. Let us take a simple example to understand this a lot better. If you see like this, the guy in the picture is nothing but Abhishek Bachchan. Now this is what he used to look like in the year 1994. Now imagine this, we are sitting in this room, it is 1994, it is Abhishek Bachchan sitting with us and he says, mere ko na duniya ki most beautiful ladki ke saath shaadi karne ki hai. I want to marry the Miss World, the Miss Universe, the best of all, I want to marry the most beautiful woman on this planet. At that time in the year 1994, it was nothing but Aishwarya Rai. So she had won the crown in the year 1994 and this is what Abhishek Bachchan looked like in the year 1994. So if Abhishek Bachchan tells us way back in 1994, mereko usko patane ka hai, what would typically the friends say to him? Arey pagal hai kya? Kaise hoega? Pagal hai kya? Out of league hai boss, not possible. Teri shakal dekh, uski shakal dekh. It's not going to happen. Now if you consider 5 years, 10 years, 20 years later, this is what it is. Happily married with a child. Now, we know all of us are thinking, "Arey, he's Abhishek Bachchan, he's Amitabh Bachchan ka beta, etc., etc." She was also bloody famous. She was also very rich. She did not require a certain Abhishek Bachchan to let her develop to the next level. So this is what we need to remember. The situation is never the problem. We need to assess the situation. It's the time which is a little concern. Waqt ko thoda waqt do. Waqt aane par waqt badal jayega, as simple as that. Give a little time, automatically assess the situation and then when you look back, it has doesn't matter. Today, do you care how much you got in 7th standard? Kisi ko farak padta hai? Kitna 10th mein kitna mila? Kisi ko farak padta hai? But agar 10th standard mein koi aapko puchta tha, hey, how much did you get? It used to burn, it used to pain. Why are people asking so much about marks? So the problem is problem at that time, it is not a problem for your lifetime. So you have to understand it is the time which is the current problem for me. Problem is never a problem. Assess it, give it some time, ask yourself, how would I think of it 5 years, 10 years from now? 5-10 saal baad mere ko iska kuch farak padega kya? Kuch farak nahi padega. And that is how you learn to accept situation rather than stressing about it. But if you are one of those who are perfectionist, jinko sab cheez perfect chahiye, then it's going to create a little issue. But make sure, problem is never a problem, the time is the problem. If the time goes ahead, automatically the problems are solved. Because most of the problems are in your mind, they are not in reality. Asal mein hote hi nahi hai problem, wo mind mein zyada hote hai. And that is how it keeps you elevated. So always remember, we need to assess the situation as we go ahead without jumping into conclusions. We have to just make sure, how would I think of this 5 years, 10 years from now? Kuch farak padega kya? Honestly, 8 out of 10 times, it wouldn't matter. What matters is how do you face it? Do you have the courage to do it or not? And if you have that, it becomes much easy to eliminate stress because now you assess the situation, you don't immediately jump and reply. And that is what we learn from this simple example. 1994, look at the face. 2014, happily married with a kid. And if this can happen with him, it can happen with all of us, as simple as that. It's a matter of time. This is what we need to learn. Now, the last part is this. It is called as thankfulness. So the last T that you see here is nothing but being thankful. Now, what does this mean?
Thank you to God, whatever you have
given. Absolutely true. Thankful, very, very gracefully, nothing but having the attitude of gratitude. Yes. We must have heard the word gratitude. Gratitude is being thankful for. So a study says, whenever you are stressed, if you have gratitude, if you are thankful for any 5 things in your world, aapke zindagi mein aise kaun se 5 cheeze hai, jinke liye aap shukraguzar ho, you are more than happy, you are so thankful that they are in their life. If you can think of those 5 people, 5 things, automatically stress is released from your brain. Aapko tension aata nahi hai. All you need to do is, you need to be thankful, you have to be thank you, you have to thank any 5 things or 5 people. Now just to help out in my head, one might be nothing but your family. Now, some of us might be most thankful for the parents that we have, for the sister, for the brother, for the kids. If anything in the world, the moment I think about my parents, I feel a lot better. That's it. Stress reduces. I am thankful ki dunya mein kitne bhi problem ho, at least I have them to look up to. Automatically, stress becomes a little less. The second, out of the five things, can be nothing but friends. Most of us, if we call our friend at midnight, sunna, problem ho gaya. Now, I am blessed with friends who would come running after me. They don't care where they are. Bhag bhag ke aa jayenge. I am thankful for those friends in my life who don't give me an excuse if I need their help. They're always there to support me. So, I am thankful for that. I have gratitude towards them. Automatically, my stress goes down. The third part can be nothing but your teachers which you have in your college. So some of us have mentors, our teachers, they are there to guide us. So as a student, you can be happy for the fact, chal paper tough gaya, chal padhai nahi hui. But at least I have this teacher with me who's going to guide me throughout ahead. So you can be happy for the person from whom you taught yourself. And that is something which is great. If nothing else, you can be grateful for nothing but maa ke haath ka khana. This is one of the best things ever. As I'm saying this, I can see most of us are smiling here because we know one thing, by duniya mein kitni bhi cheez buri ho, kitna bhi tension ho, ghar ja ke maa ke haath ka khana agar milega na, to bas, baki sab theek hai, everything else can be managed. The moment we say it, we already have smiles on our face. And this shows that your stress reduces already because you have a smile, because you are thankful for the fact that you can eat such wonderful food. And that is why we have to reduce our stress level as we go ahead. It can be, it's a symbolic representation. It can be Bollywood films, it can be Hollywood films, your TV series, music. Anything that helps you to relax yourself, you should be thankful for that. That no matter what happens, jab koi nahi tha, tab main music sunta tha, I used to feel better. That's it. I am very happy. I have gratitude towards that. The moment in the matter of stress, if we can take a moment and say, boss, I am feeling very stressed, bahut waat lagi hai, but in 5 cheezo ke liye main bahut dil se khush hu. I am very happy that these 5 things are with me. And if you can recollect all 5 things, try to create an image, automatically the stress level goes down. And even before you take any actions in the stressed mind, you come back to being normal. And that is why it is so very important. Always and always we have to make sure that we treat the stress. And the last part, we have to be thankful. No matter what happens, we have to maintain the attitude of gratitude is what we look at. And if you're thankful, definitely stress is eliminated. So towards the end as we come ahead, now we saw the causes of stress, the current education system, how it creates stress. We saw the methodology to make sure we eliminate stress. It had 5 key elements. The first one was tribe. Find your tribe, like-minded people around you. Second one was reward. Reward the actions, not the results. Results are okay, everybody will reward. Nobody rewards the actions, you reward the actions. Third, energize yourself. Change the body language for a reason. You cannot be sad in an open body language. You cannot be happy in a closed body language. So if you want to be happy, change your body language to an open body language. Automatically you will be happy. Next is nothing but assess the situation. The problem is a problem right now. In 2025, the same problem would not matter. Today, I don't care about 10 standard percent, 11 standard percent, 6 standard percent. But as a 10-year-old during those days, I used to care. Wo mere liye bahut bada problem tha. Aaj when I look back at my life, it's not a problem. So we need to make sure we assess the situation before jumping into it in a stressed mind. And at the end, we should be thankful for 5 things in our life. It can be anything. Friends, family, food, whatever comes to your mind. If you're thankful for them, stress level automatically goes down. And that is how all of us together can make sure that we can treat the stress that we have and eliminate it to a level that it doesn't affect us. Can we completely reduce it to zero?
No.
Maybe not, because everyday life will throw a new challenge at us. But do we know how to handle it? Yes, we know how to treat it. And if you can do that, then that is all that we require towards the end to treat ourselves. Now, let us look at the positives of the education system around in the world. Now, this is what it is. We have to treat our stress, making sure we have a tribe, we have a reward, we energize, we assess, and we are thankful for the any 5 things in our life. This is the best education system in the world. Now, I know some of us are wondering that, you know, which is the best education system? If Indian education system is such, then which is the best? The best one, according to the survey done by Forbes, is nothing but the education system of Finland. So there's a country called as Finland. Their education system is the number one in the world. On an average, every day, they have only 3 hours of school, out of which half an hour is for lunch break. So only 2.5 hours of school every day. Total 16 hours in a week, that's it. For most of us, 16 hours is like 2 days of school, 8 hour school from 7 to 2, 7 to 3. That is what they have in an entire week. So one of the researchers went to Finland to find out that how did your country establish the number one system in the world. So while doing it, the person asked the question, what do you teach your children? They say, first of all, we don't teach our children. We create a learning environment wherein they learn from themselves. They learn from the people around them. So if a student wants to climb a tree, the teacher says, yes, go ahead, climb a tree, but let me know, what did you observe on that tree? Can you climb it on the first attempt? Did you fall down? Did you see an insect? Collect every information that you have during this experience of climbing a tree. So the student comes back, shares the experience with everyone, and that is how they learn how to learn. Because when they go out in the outer world, any which ways you go to any job, they are going to train you for that job. It's not as if day one you start working. Training hoga. Wo training so kaise samjhe aur seekhe is what is taught in the Finland education system. And that is the best part about them. In Finland, the highest salary is not of an IT engineer. It's not of a doctor. It's not of a lawyer. It's of a teacher. And that is the difference why their education system is the best in the world. Today you consider India, we have schools wherein the teachers are paid 3,000 rupees a month or less than that. Would you as a teacher teach a student if you get such a low salary? We wouldn't. And then we blame the system. So it's a big circle that we eliminate step by step, but we have inspiration that we look up to. And is educational success related to happiness in life? Is it related? Depends, right? But here's a classic example of Finland, the education system number one in the world. Now, when it comes to happiness index in the world, Finland is number one in the world. So during this, when the survey was done 2015 to 2017, it was the happiest country in the world. It simply shows that if you have the right education system, definitely people in the country will be a lot happier. Now I know some of us are wondering, what rank is the Indian country? Apna country kaun se rank pe hai? So out of 189 countries which participated in this global index for happiness, India ranked at 130 out of 189. Imagine where we are in terms of our happiness index. And that is how we and you can turn the education system together, by not trying to change the system altogether, first trying to change ourselves by making sure we develop a habit of learning something on our own, develop self-learning as a module for ourselves, make sure that we treat the stress around us, and make sure that the country rises and becomes the number one when it comes to the happiness index and setting up the education system that we would be proud of. So to conclude, this is what it is. So we started with a slide wherein we said university makes me feel sad, anxious, etc., etc. So here's a dream that we have to make sure this happens. The next time when we type on Google, education is, we want these results to be true, because they are, education is important, key to success, our right, powerful weapon from darkness to light. This is what education should truly stand for the next time we go ahead and we Google. It shouldn't make us feel sad. It should rather make us feel happy, feel proud. It shouldn't clip our wings. It should rather give us a flight and ready to take off to the dreams that we always wanted. And that is how we come to an end today, to make sure, if you are a student watching this, make sure you treat the stress around you and take those small efforts to continue and become a lifelong learner. Thank you so much. It was a wonderful experience being here once again, and I look forward to coming back again. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.